Just because that is some serious threats. Oh, don't tell me this is gonna be a quiet day after I fucking turned down the mayor. This is gonna be a quiet day, isn't it? Oh. Well, already it's worth that I didn't send anyone to that fucking protest. Child molestation. A schoolgirl, Kathleen Camps, said that her friend Stacy Peng gave their teacher a greeting card decorated with a heart, and the teacher made an obscene joke and told her to come to his office after school. I pretended that I was leaving, but then I went back to listen at the door. The frightened girl continued. First they were talking quietly, and then there was a commotion and screaming and crying. Alright, yeah, we're gonna send a couple of cops there. Prostitution. Fuck. Russell Cipher is enraged at the presence of prostitutes along the road on the outskirts of the city. Apparently there are a dozen prostitutes lined up and they're practically throwing themselves at the passing vehicles. Some are exposing their breasts and asses in an attempt to attract customers. Get over here right away and deal with this shamelessness. Wilson. Alright, I'm not that concerned about it. I mean, if cops come back soon enough that I can send someone out, fine. Otherwise, I will let that one slide. This one was a bit of my bad resource management. So, everyone was unharmed. Ooh, and we got automatic weapons. Yes, ask the mafia to sell them. Prostitute. Everyone escapes. Good for them. I don't give a fuck. I think prostitution should be legal. And those prostitutes should be protected. Through the glass doors, you can see a male figure trying to climb on top of a struggling woman who he's thrown onto the couch. The schoolgirl is crying loudly. Go get the school. No. Knock on the door. No. Knock loudly on the door and order the man to open it. There we go. Sick fuck, I swear. Alright. A hysterical young person just called in shouting, "Good God! The prophecy has come to pass. Dozens of zombies are roaming the park just like from the movies. Oh my God, Vampires Freeburg is doomed. Send the National Guard." So I have to send a minimum of 2 people, which fucking sucks. Well, it says mass riot. I don't know if I would classify it as a mass riot from what is being said. To me, it sounds like a standard zombie walk. Not a riot, just a bunch of people gathered in one place. We'll send 2 people. I'm not really... God, Chief, this is a joke, right? Fine. What if I send the SWAT team with you? No? Fine. Then it's just gonna be 3 cops. There. Oh my God. Yeah, the man was frightened by a horror film festival. That's about what I fucking thought. That's why I only wanted to send 1 of you, but I had to send 2 of you, and because 2 of you don't think you could handle what is clearly an insane-sounding fucking call, I had to send 3 of you. But, I mean, I guess you're back before any other calls have been made. So, whatever. Okay, domestic disturbance. Mrs. Kazmi complains that her neighbors are arguing very intensely. They're a young, hot-headed couple, and and it sounds, looks like they're about to come to blows. Okay, so domestic disturbance, we're going to send two, one for each person, separate the couple, talk with them, all that. All right. A woman says she was out for an evening jog and she noticed a black guy in a hood following behind her. I was able to get away from him, but I'm afraid this bastard is still lurking in the park waiting for one of the other girls. I mean, it is, I understand she's frightened. Creeps do tend to hang out in parks. I'm not convinced yet, though, that this was, from the sound of it, he didn't lay a hand on her. He didn't try to coax her into a more secluded area or anything. But we'll go and at least check it out just to make sure. Domestic disturbance. No one was quarreling. The man was working out to a loud TV. The woman was making a salad, cut her finger rather badly, and was running to a neighbor's to call an ambulance. Her husband was only trying to stop the bleeding with a towel. So, hurry, there's some guys here who caught a transvestite and decided they'd work him over. They stripped off the guy's tights and they're acting like they're going to lynch him with them. They say they're gonna hang him over the bar. Okay. Two cops and a paddy wagon. Suspicious individual. The man in question is a medical student who also runs at night. Yeah, I kind of figured that. Anything else? Anything else? Oh, we have some more here. Although that doesn't necessarily mean anything. So we have that. Then we have that. Have that. 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 Oh shit, so there's ones for each, but not actually enough of any one person to fill that up, so we're gonna have to wait till we have more pictures. And this was attempted murder. Oh, okay, so we'll send a couple more. Day's almost over, we just need to hear about how this ends. Oh, okay. And they were able to catch them, no officers were harmed, and no civilians were harmed, so we're good. And the day, and we did end up needing all those detectives anyway, so, I mean, that's a bonus. Rogers is responsible for Freeburg PD breakdown. Twister, strip club owner, my dancers are all feminists. Crazy Arms film flop.
All the information about Laura, just like you asked.
Mr. Boyd, keep your voice down. Someone could be listening.
Oh, I'm sorry, Emma. It's my first time doing something like this. Here's the envelope. Everything's in there.
Fine. Mr. Boyd, please write for Mr. Fry on this envelope and drop it in the mailbox across the street.
What? I don't want this handled like it's some kind of game.
Mr. Boyd, those are the rules. Now please, lower your voice.
Fine. Okay, Emma. I'll put this envelope in the mailbox across the street, just like you said. Wonder how that damn Mr. Fry is gonna get an envelope out of the mailbox.
Talking to yourself, Mr. Boyd? And we thought we'd have to catch you at the police station. But it turns out Jack Boyd has come down to meet us personally. Do you know why we're here, Mr. Boyd?
I don't even know who you are.
My name is Eugene Chaffee. I'm a businessman. Rather, a restaurateur. Although I usually tell everyone I'm a businessman. Which sounds better? Businessman or restaurateur?
Oh, I think I've heard of you. You have a restaurant and a slaughterhouse. And you serve refried veal steaks.
Well, refried veal steaks isn't my only business. But perhaps it's what I'm best known for. I thought it was time we meet Mr. Boyd and my friend here. I believe you're already acquainted. His name is Troy Starr.
Never heard of him. So what do you want, Mr. Chaffee? Looking for a spokesman for your beef products? I recently changed my image and my hair.
Eugene and I really want to help you, Mr. Boyd. Although after our phone call, I've had my doubts. I was making love to my wife and you called me and told me to fuck myself. That kind of behavior is rude and inappropriate, Mr. Boyd.
I didn't mean to offend you, Mr. Starr. Just thumbing my nose at that prick mayor of ours. You keep making love to your wife, or did I ruin the mood?
There's a nice cafe around the corner. Spare us a couple of minutes of your time, Mr. Boyd. Lately, I've been so busy that I rarely get to sit and relax in such a nice place. And with such interesting company.
Get to the point, Mr. Chaffee. I'm busy, too. In fact, I think I hear some teenagers next door robbing and raping an old woman. Maybe she's your aunt.
You see, Mr. Boyd.
Good morning. What do you want?
A big mug of beer.
We don't serve big mugs of beer.
Then a small mug of beer.
We don't have beer in any size glasses. This is a family restaurant. Moms and dads come with small children. I can bring you a lollipop to suck on.
Monica, where's your famous charm? Bring the gentleman a beer. I'm sure you've got a bottle under the counter. Check between the dead cats and the dried heads of your ex-boyfriends. This man, by the way, is your police chief.
Don't be silly. The police chief has a bald spot the size of a toilet seat.
So, as I was...
Oh, I'm sorry, Eugene. It's Rogers. Probably forgot how to wipe his ass.
When you're 82, Troy, you'll probably forget you need to wipe your ass at all. But very well. Run along. We can continue without you. So, Mr. Boyd, as you may already know, the official job of my old friend Mr. Starr is to cause trouble for you. But believe me, it's not out of malice. It's to maintain his cover at City Hall. But to somewhat balance out this trouble, I've decided to help you out. Every day, pay close attention to your morning newspaper, Mr. Boyd. You'll find messages hidden among the pages. Simple notes, but make no mistake, the information you'll find there is extremely useful. You see, Troy Starr isn't my only spy. That's it, Mr. Boyd. I told you it would only take a couple of minutes. I wouldn't want to disturb you while you're enjoying your drink. Keep in touch, my dear little cupcake. Oh, yes, I'm quite good at puns.
Never imagined what meeting Robespierre would be like. But I certainly didn't figure the first thing he'd do was buy me a drink. Getting them to serve a beer at a family cafe? And this Robespierre has some strange superpowers. Strange, but not entirely useless.
Well, that was really interesting, and we got to meet Robespierre, so... Oh my god, I drank too much. I don't think I can hold it together today. Can I go home? Fuck no. You left work. Oh my god, you are fucking fired. How about that? You're fucking fired. When I come back, because after I'm done with a few things here, I need to log off. But you're fired, bitch. And no, you can't go home. Work drunk. bitch. Oh my god. I'm actually a little pissed off. Oh wait, we don't have a... Can we... Options. So I may not be able to fire her when I come back. But either way, my dog is harassing me. I think she has to go to the bathroom, and I only had 8 minutes left that I was going to record anyway. So I think I'm going to stop it short here, and I will see you next time. Thank you for watching.